Brothers, respected elders, all praises for Allah, the Lord of the universe, and we thank Him for having blessed us with Iman and Islam, and made us in the Ummah of His beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah guides those whom Allah wills. Hidayat, guidance, all وَالْقَدْرِ خَيْرِهِ وَشَرِّهِ مِنَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. All good and bad is from Allah. Allah has created all of us. هو الذي خلقكم فمنكم كافر ومنكم مؤمن. Allah has created all people, and from them Allah made some believers and some as kafirs. ولو شاء ربك لآمن من في الأرض كلهم جميعا. If Allah so wanted, all the people of the world could have been believers. But that is not the way Allah decided things to be. Allah decided to create people and bless some with Iman and deprive others. In another verse Allah says in the Quran, وَقُلِ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. Allah has revealed the truth and made everything clear, and whosoever wants to believe, then let him believe, and whosoever wants to deny, then let them deny. Haqq is from Allah. Allah guides those whom Allah wills. But Allah has made a rule, a sunnah, qanoon. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. Allah guides those whom He wills, but Allah will guide those who will strive and struggle. And strive and make effort, Allah will guide them. A person can't simply sit at home and relax and be complacent and not show any care and worry and concern and thinks everything will be okay. It will not be okay. Allah has made dunya darul asbab. If Allah wants, at the blink of an eye, if Allah so wishes, all the people of the world, the Jews, the Christians, the Hindus, the Sikhs, the Africans, the Asians, the Americans, the Arabs, the non-Arabs, all the people in the world in the spur of the moment can all become Muslims and believers. But Allah didn't make it that way. Allah sent His beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as rahmatul lil alameen wa ma arsalnaka illa kafatan lin nasi bashiran wa nadhira, and commanded His beloved Prophet, ya ayyuhar rasul balligh ma unzila ilayka min rabbik wa in lam taf'al fama ballaghta risalata. Convey my message, and if you don't, you would not have fulfilled the right of conveying and preaching and risala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam simply just did not sit and make dua in the vicinity of the Kaaba in front of Hajr al-Aswad. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went from door to door, and he went, and whenever he had the opportunity, in whatever form, whenever, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tried to explain to people, to make them realize. He went to Taif, and he was stoned. And when he had the opportunity to pray against them, and the angel came and he said, ya Rasulullah, if you want, I can bring the mountains together on either side of the town and crush these people. If you want, I can do that. Or anything else which you suggest and recommend. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in spite of having this opportunity, then chose to forgive these people and pray for their hidayat. And he said, I am hopeful, if these people don't believe, then in their offspring, generations to come, there will be people who will believe. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most beloved Prophet of Allah, regarding whom Allah took a pledge even from all the prophets. وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ النَّبِيِّينَ لَمَا آتَيْتُكُم مِّن كِتَابٍ وَحِكْمَةٍ ثُمَّ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مُصَدِّقٌ لِّمَا مَعَكُمْ لَتُؤْمِنُنَّ بِهِ وَلَتَنصُرُنَّهُ. All the prophets had to offer their pledge and promise that when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam appears, even they will believe in him and assist him. So noble Imamul Anbiya, Sayyidul Anbiya, Sayyidul Awwalina wal Akhirin. In the night of Mi'raj, Allah gathered the prophets, and Allah blessed and honored His beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the opportunity to lead all the prophets in salah and be their imam. But even he had to go from people to people and preach the message of Allah, and he did not just become complacent and become content with only his du'as. Du'as are also essential. We have to ask Allah to guide us. And in the hadith which I recited, Allah says, Ya ibadi, kullukum dalun illa man hadaytuhu. All of you people, you are all misled. You are all on the wrong path except those whom I guide. And when Allah guides people, مَنْ يَهْدِهِ اللَّهُ فَلَا مُدِلَّ لَهُ. When Allah guides people, then no one can mislead them. وَمَنْ يُدْلِلِ اللَّهُ فَلَا هَادِيَ لَهُ. And when Allah misguides them, then nobody can guide them. Real guidance comes from Allah. Allah is the one who changes the hearts. يَا مُقَلِّبَ الْقُلُوبِ. In some of the du'as of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya muqallib al-qulub, Ya musarrif al-qulub, sarrif qulubana ila ta'atik, ya muqallib al-qulub, sabbit qalbi ala deenik. Oh, he who changes the hearts, who twists the hearts, manipulates the hearts, turn my heart to your ta'ah, to your obedience. And Ya Allah, the Lord who flips the heart. Sometimes a person can be a Muslim and a believer, and an obedient person to Allah, and trying to pray and do these things, all of a sudden something can happen, and that person can flip and change. That is why Allah has taught us a dua in the Quran as well. رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِقْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا. Ya Allah, having given us guidance, don't change our hearts away from guidance, away from Islam. There are many a people, Allahu Akbar, they come into Islam, or they come into deen, and by some means or another, then Allah deprives them. And these people, then they go away. And then Allah sometimes doesn't even give them tawfiq to come back. كَيْفَ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ قَوْمٌ كَفَرُوا بَعْدَ إِيمَانِهِمْ وَشَاهِدُوا أَنَّ الرَّسُولَ حَقٌ وَجَاءَهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ. How will Allah possibly guide those people whom Allah blessed and Allah gave them guidance and made everything clear to them, and they chose to go against the commands of Allah and to turn away from the deen of Allah? Allah will never guide such people. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِ الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. What bigger zulm than this? Allah gave a person guidance, understanding of Islam, and enlightened their hearts with the nur of Iman, and then such people, then they chose otherwise. Then they chose otherwise. Allah has mentioned a story in the Quran about one such man, بَلْعَمْ بَعُورٍ. وَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا فَانْسَلَخَ مِنْهَا فَأَتْبَعَهُ الشَّيْطَانُ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ. Allah says, Oh my beloved Prophet, tell them about the man. I had blessed and given him guidance. He was a pious man, a saintly man. And then, but subhanAllah, Shaitan was on his case, and then he gave in to Shaitan. Shaitan is on everybody's case from the beginning till the end. He doesn't give up. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahimahullah, when he was about to die, people, they were encouraging him to recite La ilaha illallah. And this is what people should do. When a person, when he's in his last moments and people think that he is about to die, then people should gather around such a person and not tell him directly to recite La ilaha illallah, but him, and in a medium voice, recite La ilaha illallah around him so that he can be encouraged to join in and recite La ilaha illallah. Because if you tell that person directly to recite La ilaha illallah, that person who's dying, he is under severe attack of shaitan at the moment. In the dying moments of a person, shaitan attacks him the most. And he knows that throughout his life he did what he did, but if he can persuade him to come away now, then his work is done. So he attacks him with full force in his dying moments. So under such pressure, don't put a person on the spot and telling him to recite La ilaha illallah. Least he should deny and say, why should I? Or just leave me alone. And then in that person, this is very severe and dangerous for that person, and could leave him to denying Iman and La ilaha illallah, in which case he could die as a kafir. But help him by reciting La ilaha illallah around him. So people gathered around Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahmahullah and making talqeen of La ilaha illallah. And he said, not yet, not yet. And then he became unconscious. And when he regained his consciousness, he said to the people, you were encouraging me to recite La ilaha illallah. And there was shaitan standing by the door. I saw him and he said, Oh Ahmad, you have escaped from my clutches. And I was telling him, not yet, not yet. I can't be too sure of myself. As long as I am alive, I can't be too sure of myself that I will die with Iman. And so shaitan tries his best to lure a person away, away from La ilaha illallah, away from deen. And so the bigger a person, the bigger the shaitan, and the more he attacks that person. So this Bal'am Ba'ur from Bani Israel, shaitan came on his case. And then he followed him. And then he gave in to him. Allah says, وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَرَفَعْنَاهُ بِهَا وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَى. Allah says, if I wanted to elevate him and save him, I could have. But this man, he fell for it. He gave preference to the glamour and the comfort of dunya. وَكَانَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَرَفَعْنَاهُ بِهَا. Then Allah says, فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلِ الْكَلْبِ إِن تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْهِ يَلْهَثْ أَوْ تَتْرُكُهُ يَلْهَثْ. He's like a dog. When you give him something, he barks. When you deprive him or when you hit him, he still barks. A dog, that's all he does, he barks. So a person who turns away from Allah, Allah made him Muslim, Allah gave him guidance, and Allah showed him the right path. But this person doesn't value it, and he gives preference to the glamour of dunya. In the eyes of Allah, such a person is like a dog. So we should repent to Allah and ask Allah to guide us. This is why Allah has made it obligatory upon every Muslim to seek hidayat from Allah. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. In 32 rakats on daily basis, 17 faraid, 3 witr, and 12 sunnah, muwakkida. We pray to Allah, ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, sirat al-ladhina an'amta alayhim, ghayri al-maghdubi alayhim wa al-dhalin. Ya Allah, show us the right path, the path of those upon whom you showered your mercy and blessings and favors, and not the path of those with whom you are angry and those who were led astray. And the ulama, they say, and those who were angry, with whom Allah was angry are the Jews, and those who were led astray are the Christians who made Isa alayhi salam as the son of Allah. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ. Surely they committed kufr, those who said that Isa ibn Maryam is the son of Allah. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَةٍ. Verily, committed kufr, those who said Allah is a third of the three, those who believe in Trinity. And the Bani Israel, لَوْإِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِن بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ. They would say, that's their business, they can do what they like. Alhamdulillah, we pray, we are okay with our deen. As long as I am alright, that's all that matters. And that's not the case for us. We are the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah has addressed this ummah as kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas. You are the best of the nations raised for the benefit of mankind, to enjoy the good and forbid the evil. And Allah says, waltakum minkum ummah. There should be a nation amongst you, special groups, a large group. Ummah isn't just a small group. Allah says, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ. There should be definitely a group amongst you, a nation amongst you. يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ. Those who invite people to the good. وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Who invite people to the good and enjoin the good and forbid the evil. Allah says, they are the ones who will be successful. Those who know Arabic, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. These are the ones who will be successful. If you want to be successful in the eyes of Allah, in this world and the life hereafter, the ultimate achievement, to enjoin the people to, and to call them to good, and to enjoin the goodness and forbid them from evil. أُمَّةٌ. And some people think, oh, it's okay, doesn't matter, you don't have to join a group. It's not just a question of joining a group. It's a question of fulfilling the responsibility which Allah has bestowed upon this ummah. خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ. The best of the nations. وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ ummah. There should be a group amongst you who invite people to good. And mashallah, with the mercy of Allah, Allah has raised such people in this time and age. And people that people say, Tablighi Jamaat, mashallah, from the east to the west and the north and the south, from every country in the world, Allah has established and spread this mubarak and blessed effort. And people, they go in the path of Allah and invite people to Allah. And there is no membership, there is no anything, and purely for the sake of Allah. And people, they go from door to door, houses to houses, every masjid from masjid to masjid, country to country, town to town, mashallah. And we are honored by guests, mashallah. They have come from Jordan, mashallah, from Amman, or Oman, Amman. Oman, from Oman, mashallah. They have come here, mashallah. They are staying with us for a few days. Mashallah, from Oman. They are going around, not asking for any donations or anything else, just visiting Muslims, mashallah, and reminding them and awakening them the responsibility which Allah has bestowed upon this ummah. قُلْ هَذِي سَبِيلِي أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي. And this is the path of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And whose path can be better than the path of Rasulullah? قُلْ هَذِي سَبِيلِي أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي. Here there is no shirt of ulama or non-ulama, and you have to know this and you have to know that. MashaAllah, whosoever claims to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just as Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, when he became a Muslim, the first day he went out and got six of his friends, MashaAllah, people like Uthman bin Affan, Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Zubair and others, MashaAllah. Abu Dharr Ghifari, the first day he became a Muslim, he did not sit around in the company of Rasulullah for so many years, and until he learned Aqidah and Fiqh and other issues and Tafsir, and then, no. Immediately, the moment he became a Muslim, he asked Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, please allow me to go and declare my faith in front of the people in the haram. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Oh Abu Zar, take it easy, go back to your people. Things aren't so easy in Makkah at the moment. When things are easy, then we will call for you. He said, No, Ya Rasulullah, please do allow me. The Prophet allowed him, he went and he chanted his shahada, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. وَأَشَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. It didn't just mean that he has become a Muslim. It was a declaration and a da'wah to others. It says that I have become Muslims, you should do the same. Tufail bin Amr Dawsi became a Muslim and he said, it means on the spur of the moment, Ya Rasulullah, allow me so that to go and preach to my people as well. Sa'd ibn Mu'az radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was from the Ansar of Medina. When he became a Muslim, the moment he became a Muslim, he gathered his people. And who do we know? Who is Sa'd ibn Mu'az? When he died after the Battle of Khandaq, and his janazah was prepared, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was seen walking on his tiptoes. And Sahaba inquired, Ya Rasulullah, how come you are walking on your tiptoes? The Prophet said, well, so many angels have come to participate in the janazah of Sa'd, there isn't even room for me to put my foot down. He said, and another narration, they said, even the arsh of Allah was shaken by the death of Sa'd. Sa'd ibn Mu'az, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And he went to his people, Banu Abdul Ashal, and he said to them, what do you think about me? He said, well, you are our chief. They said, you are our chief. He said, I will not talk to your men, to your women, until all of you become Muslim. He didn't give them much daleel. He didn't give them much lecture. The moment he became a Muslim, he went to them and he said to them, you must all become Muslims. And 80 families became a Muslim on his da'wah, mashallah. The very first day he became a Muslim. Allah has mentioned an incident of jinns in the Quran. وَإِسْرَفْنَا إِلَيْكَ نَفَرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنِ فَلَمَّا حَضَرُوهُ قَالُوا أَنْسِتُوا فَلَمَّا قُذِيَ وَلَّوْا إِلَى قَوْمِهِمْ مُنْذِرِينَ قَالُوا يَا قَوْمَنَا إِنَّا سَمِعْنَا كِتَابًا أُنْزِلَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مُوسَى مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْحَقِّ وَإِلَى طَرِيقٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ يَا قَوْمَنَا أَجِيبُوا دَاعِيَ اللَّهِ وَآمِنُوا بِهِ يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ مِنْ ذُنُوبِكُمْ وَيُجِرْكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ وَمَنْ لَا يُجِبْ دَاعِيَ اللَّهِ فَلَيْسَ بِمُعْجِزٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَمَا لَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا نَصِيرٍ. The jinns, they became Muslims. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't even know, and they went back to the people, to Nasibin in Iraq. And they gather the people and they encourage them to become Muslims. And the beloved Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam only knew of this issue when Allah revealed Surah Jinn, قُلْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ أَنَّهُ اسْتَمَعَ نَفَرٌ مِّنَ الْجِنِّ فَقَالُوا إِنَّا سَمِعْنَا قُرَانَنَا عَجَبًا يَهْدِي إِلَى الرُّشْدِ فَآمَنَّا بِهِ وَلَنْ نُشْرِكَ بِرَبِّنَا أَحَدًا. Ibn Kathir Allah has written up to 70,000 jinns. They became Muslims on various different occasions. Among them once was a jinn called Hama bin Him bin Lahim bin Laqis bin Iblis. And Ibn Kathir rahimahullah has written this in Al-Isaba fi Tamizi Sahaba. And she said, he came to the Prophet once, Ya Rasulullah, my name is Hama. I'm the son of Him bin Lahim bin Laqis bin Iblis, great grandson of Iblis. And he says, when Habil and Qabil, when Qabil killed Habil, I was a young man, kuntu fita. Thumma aslamtu ma Nuh. Then I became a Muslim at the hands of Nuh alayhi salam. ثم كنت مع إبراهيم وموسى وداود وسليمان وعيسى عليه الصلاة والسلام. Then I was with Ibrahim عليه السلام and Suleiman عليه السلام, Isa عليه السلام, and Isa عليه السلام said to me, if I remain alive and you appear, I should convey you his salam. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Aisha رضي الله عنها, she said, Hama في الجنة. Hama will be in Jannah. So many jinns, mashallah, jinns, sahaba, and how they spread the effort of deen. And mashallah, today people think, oh, this is bidah, this is this, and this is that. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not put a stall out in any high street. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not distribute cassettes and videos and other things. I am not saying that's wrong. Whatever is needed at the time, mashallah. And these people also, brothers, mashallah, from east to the west and north and the south, they were jahidu bi amwali wa anfusim fi sabilillah. They go in the path of Allah with their own time, with their spare. All of them, family members, businessmen, others, mashallah. But they spare the time to go in the path of Allah, visiting, encouraging, reminding, bringing people. And you think it's easy? You think it's easy to sit down and say, fatwa, kufr, shirk, bidah, hada, hada, hada. But it's easy to say that. But to do something and to prove, وَأَمَّا مَا يَنْفَعُ النَّاسَ فَيَنْكُثُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Whatever is useful for people, Allah will establish it far and wide. MashaAllah, just a few, some time ago, the year before, last year we had ulama, MashaAllah, from Madinatul Munawwara, from Makkah Mukarramah, MashaAllah. We had a jamaat from Riyadh, MashaAllah, brothers from Oman, MashaAllah. 3-4 years ago we had a sheikh from Amman, Jordan. Then he came, MashaAllah. People all over the world, from Fiji, Australia, Japan, MashaAllah, Malaysia, Taiwan, Indonesia, China, Russia, all over Arabia, all over Africa, MashaAllah, Somalia, Algeria, in Morocco, America, everywhere, MashaAllah. Allah is taking work of deen, and people like these, MashaAllah, are going out, bringing people to Islam, making jola, mulaqah, ziyarat, pubs, clubs, streets, everywhere. The young and the old, MashaAllah, this is Allah's fadl. ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ. Allah gives it to those who want. Those who criticize, I'll just tell you a story. Somebody, mashallah, he made a picture, painted a picture, a nice picture, and he said, brothers, if you find anything wrong, please advise me underneath. He put a, bhi ye tasveer hai, agar isme koi nuks ho, kuch is tarah koi mashwara ho, to niche list la de. He hung it out, mashallah. By the end of the day, long list of that's wrong, that's wrong, that's wrong, long list criticism. The next day he put the same picture up and he says, brother, if there's anything wrong, please correct it. If there's anything wrong, then correct it. It was there for 6 months, not a single change. It's easy to criticize, but do something better yourself. Bidah, shirk, bidah, mashallah. But this ummah Allah has sent, we bring people to Allah. Yassiru wa la tuassiru, bashiru wa la tunaffiru. And to bring people into Islam, if many people had their ways, they will make more than half the ummah as kafirs. هذا كافر هذا مشرك هذا هو هذا هو هذا هو بس كأنه هو بس. As though he is the only man going to Jannah. Brother, you should fear Allah. Allah will decide. ادعو إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة وجادل بالتي هي أحسن إن ربك هو أعلم بمن ضل عن سبيله وهو أعلم بالمهتدين. Allah will decide on the day of Qiyamah. We should try for the sake of Allah, for the pleasure of Allah, doing the best we can, mashallah, in light of the guidance given to us by ulama. And mashallah, yes, nobody is perfect. The last perfect person in this world was none other than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who is beyond any criticism. Other than that, no sheikh, yes, imams, Abu Hanifa, Rahimahullah, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, Imam Bukhari, Ibn Taymiyyah, Albani, whosoever. Everyone, you can criticize everyone, whatever you want. And no one is beyond criticism. But we should fear Allah. To criticize someone, we have to be better than them. To mark someone who is doing graduation, his papers, you got to be a master or a PhD. To criticize, it's easy to open one's mouth and criticize, but to do something, mashallah. That's much more difficult. So these people, mashallah, are doing something rather than encourage. وَتَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى. We should assist one another in matters of piety and goodness. Not put each other down. MashaAllah. There are all sorts of things happening in this world. But in this time and age, Allah is our witness. Allah knows. And Allah has accepted this effort, mashallah, from east to the west, north and the south. Millions, literally hundreds of millions of people Allah has blessed and brought to the right path. Sunnah, fara'id, iman, people living on the verge of kufr. away from Islam, Allah has brought whole families and tribes and clans, mashallah, and individuals. No one is perfect. No one who goes with Jamaat al-Da'wah or Tabligh, we will say he will become Jibreel or Mikael or Rasul. No. He will remain the same, Abdullah, Muhammad, Saeed, whatever. And but mashallah, it brings a change, benefits people. And mashallah, tuba li abdin ja'ala Allahu miftahan lil khair wa mighlaqan lil shar. Blessings for those Allah uses and to guide people and bring people to the right path. This is such an honor Allah has bestowed upon this ummah, upon this ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah has blessed them with the opportunity to do the work of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the work of da'wah. And in this time and age of fitr and fasad, there is no bigger honor, no bigger tawfiq, no bigger goodness than for a person to be able to talk about Allah and bring people to deen. MashaAllah. And man tashabbaha biqawmin fahuwa minhum. We cannot be prophets. There is no more prophet after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But anybody who does the work of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah will raise him with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of Qiyamah. And we ask Allah to do the same for us. To have mercy upon us.